Alrighty guys, welcome back here to another episode of Sly 3, Honor Among Thieves. We have to head out for Operation Turbo Dominant Eagle. Whereabouts are we heading? We're heading up here? We sure are. We've got to head up to the top of the Black Baron's house. That is the wrong button, whoops. Yes! Free loot. I mean, it's all free if they don't know you're taking it. Ta-da! Oh, and silent obliteration. Obliteration, I forgot about that. Meow. Oh, yep, someone's getting mauled by the damn wolf. Hopefully we don't lose our head like Bentley did in the last episode. Oh, that's right, and we can sneak now. Completely invisible. Completely. We can pull a Bentley.
Sounds straightforward enough. Where'd you get these trackers? They look kind of funny.
Best I could do on short notice. They're sensitive to extreme changes in altitude. You'll have to pull this job off at high elevation or it's a bust.
Shouldn't be a problem.
So, I actually have to continuously stay up in the air, as in not touching the ground. Holy crap. I don't even know if I'm gonna make this first one. Oh my god, does it count? Oh, it does, thank god. Hell yeah. Alright, now I gotta jump off to this one. Oh, that is so high. Thank you, Bentley. How the hell am I gonna make it to this one? I reckon I gotta wait. Aw, oh, look at these cute little plane flyers again. Just versing each other. Little cuties. Alright, how the hell am I gonna make it up to this? I don't think I am. I have to make it to this one. Probably. I didn't know there was one all the way over there. I didn't see that. On the schematics. Can I make it? Am I gonna make it? Ah, easy. All the way over there. I reckon I can make it to this middle one. And then across. Oh no, it's turning. Guys. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, please don't blow up, bomb. Please somehow I got caught on this. No! Bum-bum-bum-bum. Oh, this one, quick, I can see it. Quick, quick, quick. Jump on this one. Catch it. No, I'm not gonna catch it from here. Where am I? How am I? They just sort of fly around anyway, because that's what it feels like. Is it smaller? I'm not gonna make this one again. How the hell? I'm gonna aim for this one. Come on. Ah, damn it. No, I blew up. And jump. You know what in hell am I making that? Alright. I'm gonna wait for this guy to take us on around. I'm gonna try and launch off as best as we can. Which one is it? It's a smaller one there. Alright, looks like we're turning around. Best chance to go would be like now. That looks better. Ta-da! Perfect landing.
Nice work, my boy. The gunship's GPS data is flowing in. Head back to the hangar and suit up. Alright, Murray. The Black Baron's communication antenna is held up by three support beams. Pull them out of place, and the whole array will fall apart.
Don't worry. If there's one thing I'm good at, it's rowing. And breaking stuff.
And now we get to show how good we are at rowing, without a head again. Uh-oh. Out of the way. Ah! Watch out for stuff. Why can't I keep going? What? Why is it pulling me back? What the hell was that? Quick, to the bridge. What? Why? What? How? I'm so confused as to why this is...
The falling blades are dangerous, but they're perfect cover for this operation.
No one's gonna have any idea I'm doing it. Ah, wrong way. It's hard when you're facing backwards. Can't see what's coming. Quick. We can do it. We can do it, Murray. Go, go, go. Yes. One more to go. Oh. Yep, this way. There's so much plane stuff. What the heck? What are you doing, Murray? Get off there. You suck at rowing. Go, go, go.
The Murray has broken him. Let that be a lesson to all the tenants. I will not be trifled with. Well, this is it. I am the tiger, pal. Look for the Black Baron. Take him out and this competition is all over. And go easy on the throttle. It's been sticking lately.
Quit worrying. I'll see you in the winner's circle.
Now it is time to kill the Baron. Where is he? Is that him right there? Yeah, it is. Doesn't look like him, but it is. Get him! He's already at half health, I love it. Doesn't even look like him driving. Come on, guys, you could have done better than that. Chase him down. Oh, that's right. I have to get bullets. Forgot about that. Ah! Bro. Whoa. Alright, where are you? There you are. Catch him. Come on, get him. Get him.
I beat you. Your biplane is in pieces.
We're both still airborne, aren't we? The victor has yet to be decided.
Then, let's settle it.
Beware, my boy. I've trained 10 years in fisticuffs. Pugilism is my passion.
If you fight as well as you fly, this shouldn't take long.
On guard!
In fisticuffs. Alright, now we gotta defeat Black Baron. in an actual hand-to-hand combat, which is, was very surprising. First time I played through this, I was not expecting him to, actually fight us. Hand-to-hand. Bro, get off me. And disappear. Ha ha! Ow! Oh! Quick! Now we gotta get rid of all these guys to get ourselves some health back. Oh my god. Oh, bye Sly. If you say so. Come on, hit me, hit me. Bro, I keep falling off this damn plane. Get off. What? Okay, I probably deserve that. Oi. Bro, get off me. Alright. Holy crap, I can do three. Well, that was some great health. Give me some more. I want more. Hell yeah. That third one is so good. Alright, by the way, when he does that, you have to jump off. Because, apparently it breaks your legs of sorts. Bro. Yeah, okay. I deserve that. Bet he wasn't expecting me to attack that quick. Come on. Come on. Fight. Yes. Defend your leader. This is real easy. When you stand there and just do this. Uh-oh. Bro. Get off me. Thank you. One more to go. Oh, wait. Oh, come on, man. Thank you. Oh, come on. He's a lot stronger than you think he'd be. Ow! He just smacks me straight in the face and I can't move. Oh, man. What? No! Yeah, that's better. Holy crap. I like that you still see him disappearing underneath that side too. Whoa. Okay. Well, this is just kind of unfair now. Now that they're attacking back a lot more. There you go. That's what I want. Oh, dude. Those heavy punches hurt so much. bro. Okay, I count that as a win. This sucks me in the head. Alright. Yes. Free health, thank you. No! I just lost it again. Okay. They are, scarier this time. Health, please. Thank you. Alright, gotta defend ourselves against him a lot more. How did I get hurt from that? Oh, I wasn't watching him, damn it. That pig. Yoink. Get off of here. We're looking a lot better this time, but I can't say I'm gonna do it because I guarantee I'm not then.
A fatal blow.
That's enough. You win, Cooper.
Wait, you? You're Penelope, the Baron's mechanic. No. No, you are the Black Baron.
Someone was bound to find out sooner or later. I guess I'm kinda relieved.
But why?
Look, let's talk on the ground where it's safe.
I know, right? Crazy plot twist. Didn't see it coming. She doesn't look like her picture.
It was quite a revelation. Penelope and the Black Baron were one and the same. But before we could even process this turn of events, we were rushed to the winner's circle. Somehow, against all odds, we become this year's champions. There was a bit of an awkward moment between Bentley and Penelope. I guess the photos they'd sent each other over the internet were a bit exaggerated. That night, Penelope explained that the disguise was invented to get her past the Dogfighting League's strict age requirements. However, after winning, the Baron became a celebrity, and she found herself putting on the costume more and more often. But now, with the Black Baron out of the picture, she was free to take up a new path, and she joined the gang without hesitation. The next day, our newest recruit treated us to a week-long aerial tour of Holland. She was fitting in just fine.
There it is, that's how we get Penelope on our team too. Let's head into a cold alliance to see who we need next, shall we?
After a careful analysis of Dr. M's fortress, Bentley came to the difficult conclusion that his demolition skills just weren't going to be enough. If we wanted to get inside the Cooper Vault, we'd have to recruit a full-time demolition specialist. However, Bentley's proposed candidate was a shock. My old enemy, the Panda King. As a member of the original Fiendish Five, he had a part in taking out my dad and stealing pages from the Thieves Raccoonus. Eventually, I caught up with him, and I claimed back what he had stolen. There was no way I was gonna let that monster on my team, but Bentley was firm. He discovered the Panda King had left his life of crime, and was now a monk living the life of quiet meditation high up in the mountains. I wasn't at all convinced, but there was no denying that he had the skills we needed if we were to succeed. So the gang packed up, put on our disguises, and headed east to China.
Stay sharp, team. For all we know, the Panda King's just as dangerous as ever.
How can you say that? Just look at him! Have you ever seen someone more at peace with the world?
I'll admit, he does look kinda zenned out.
Mr. King? Honorable Panda King? We humbly wish to speak with you!
I guess he doesn't want to talk. Sorry, Bentley. Let's go.
Be realistic, Sly. He's clearly in a deep meditative trance. It'll take some doing, but I think I see a way to get the team up to his shrine.
Good. The walk up here tired me out. I don't want to turn around now. Man, I missed the van. We never had to walk anywhere back then.
Okay. Let's just get this over with.
Murray, you're up first. If you could get to the top of that pillar, you should be able to use your ball move to bounce all the way up to the Panda King.
Okay, bouncing is a lot easier than more walking. Seriously, you guys want to see my blisters?
No way. Is he serious?
Hum-a-da-da. Hum-na-ha.
Yeah, okay, Master. Bouncing, pillars, piece of cake.
Ha, avu-do-da.
I hear that. Sometimes you've got to be firm.
No, seriously. Was he for real about the blisters? Because, I don't know, it's... yeesh.
Alright, we gotta head up there. With some of Murray's ancient Australian, bouncing? I'm pretty sure that's what the technical term was, wasn't it? That was easy. Alright, let's go for a roll. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, head over to here. Show everybody that we made it. I think.
Okay, I'm in position!
Penelope, you're up next. I'm not sure if you're aware, but Sly can jump onto small points. Those bamboo shoots would be an ideal means of ascent if they weren't spaced so far apart.
Hold on. Let me see if I can figure it out for myself.
It's, got to do with the ice.
Okay, so clearly we need more points in order for Sly to ascend. The problem? Where we're going to get them. The answer? Split each chute down the middle, thereby doubling the points of ascension. However... the ice down there appears too thin to walk on, so there's no way to do it by hand. So, I'll need to use my lightweight remote control car to split the trees for us.
Perfect! That's it, exactly!
Great! Anything for Sly. I love to see him pull off those athletic moves.
Good thing I installed a turret on this little lady.
What the heck? She likes Sly. Aha! We just gotta pop all these bamboos open. Boom! Split them in half for Sly to get up. Last one here. Nope, we got more. Where? Ah, the first one. Ha! 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 I shot it!
Thanks. It looks great.
My pleasure. Really? Anytime.
Sly, isn't it time you climbed up there and joined Murray?
Yeah, sure.
That's getting creepy. Sly likes Carmelita. I love the sound of this place. It is so reminiscent of the first game. But the coming level with when we're trying to recruit the Panda King, he it is a bit scary. Has a bit of a Contessa vibe to it.
Whack the supports up on those pinwheels.
Really?
Pinwheel destabilization is the cornerstone of this plan.
Jump into my hands and I'll throw you up there.
How do I... Okay, yeah, that works. Hiya! And hiya!
I'm all done up here.
Excellent. Now that the pinwheels are unstable, I just need to light them up with my darts. One shot per rocket should do the trick.
Time to go shooting, Bentley. Nope, didn't work. Okay, gotta time it. No, I keep hitting the same spot. Nailed it. Nailed it.
Persuade the guards to help you get up to those rockets.
Oh, hiya.
Persuading guards, hey? Also, we got new things that we can transform into. Boom. Okay, never mind. There's one that's the same. A bonsai tree? I think there's a third. Firework rockets. Hell yeah. How do I get a... Oh, alright, that works. One more.
Strong work. That fallen pinwheel should serve as an excellent makeshift elevator.
Hola, Radada.
Let's go. Whoop, put up. Hell yeah. Hello.
Agree. He's in a super meditative state.
So let's just shout in his ear.
Now, to break him out of this trance, we'll need to delve into his mind.
A hacksaw, then?
No! It'll require channeling.
Hi, what a da.
Sly, sit beside the Panda King. The guru will bridge your minds.
I see you carry the cane of the notorious Cooper Thief Clan. Have you come here for revenge? To steal back the thievius raccoons?
Whoa! This is just like the time I beat the stuffing out of you.
Why should you care if I bury a few worthless villagers in the snow? You are a thief, just like me.
Yeah, are you even listening to what I'm saying?
Insolent child! You shall pay dearly for your disrespect. Still, to honor your Cooper ancestry, I will send you to your doom with the beauty of my new firework technique, Flame Fool.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, nice head, stupid Panda King. I'm invisible. Escape. Ow. Jump. This is like exactly the same battle. It's so easy.
Snap out of it. This is all in your head.
My mind is clear, focused on your destruction.
I've got to break him out of this memory loop. Maybe I should threaten him, play nice, make him sad. Let's make him sad.
I don't know why you're here. You're fixated on the moment of your greatest defeat. I beat you, and forever after you've wondered how it all fell apart.
I hate you, Sly Cooper. You've ruined me. Ruined the Panda King.
And I've hated you, but that doesn't make any of this real. Years have passed, and we both changed. Come out of this trance. Let's meet each other as we are today, and let go of who we were when this fight occurred.
You are... correct. Forgive me. My mind is not always my own.
The Panda King wasn't any more excited about the notion of him joining the gang than I was. If it weren't for the guru, who for some reason really hit it off with the old guy, the whole deal would have been a bust. We could see the anger in the Panda King's eyes as he recounted how he lost a member of his own family. A daughter who was abducted by a powerful general from the northern mountains. She was to be the bride in a forced marriage to this unscrupulous ruler, and Panda King was exiled. We agreed to help him recover his lost daughter in exchange for his skills in the Cooper Vault job. I still wasn't convinced this was a good idea, but a deal's a deal.
And there it is, guys. The controversy of this episode being someone on his team killed his father. I don't know how Sly is going to get through this one. Thank you so much for watching this episode, though, guys. I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Goodbye. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Make sure you are subscribed and hit that like button if you want to see more. Thank you again. Bye.